Well, it's the same rivalry, but a new-look Nottingham Panthers side with the addition of Julian Talbot and Jake Hansen. Sheffield have had a good record against the Panthers in the Challenge Cup with just one loss in four games. But Aaron Fox is keen to stress that form counts for nothing against a side they haven't faced for 6 weeks. The Panthers are unbeaten in their last seven domestic games, while Sheffield have been pretty inconsistent on the road. But here at the arena, it's been a different story with four wins in their last five. So there's no Anthony De Luca tonight for Sheffield. He serves a one-game suspension for that check to a head in Glasgow last weekend. Aaron Johnson is out after re-injuring his hand away at Glasgow on Sunday after 10 weeks out. So frustrating, that. And Robert Dowd was a doubt after failing to finish the game in Glasgow, but it looks like he plays tonight. The good news is Michael Davis also returns after a six-game suspension. He's been missed 18 points in 18 games, including 9 goals. He's played 3 of the 4 cup games against the Panthers, scoring in all 3. And the Steelers will be hoping for more of the same tonight. In terms of Nottingham, they've made additions. They've brought in Jake Hansen, he's been so impressive, and also Julian Talbot. So running you through the lines, Kevin Carr is starting in goal. They've got Hansen, Pellini and Sam Herr, the captain. Bulmer, Talbot and Quist. Jonathan Rolt, Ollie Bettridge and Dylan Manquist. And then Jordan Castle, Lakowitz and Hazel Dine as well. So the ones to watch, we've already mentioned him. Jake Hansen has been at the heart of the Nottingham revival. 9 goals, 11 points in 10 domestic games. His form has really surprised many. He only managed 6 during his spell with the Coventry Blaze last season. Meanwhile, Julian Talbot has been the beating heart of Nottingham inside the face-off circle in his 4 games. 62% of his battles have been won. John Armstrong likes these rivalry games, scored some big goals against Nottingham over the years. He was on fire the last time these teams met at the arena, scoring twice in a 4-3 win. He has the most face-off wins in the league, 298 in total, so an average of 56% inside the circle. It'd be interesting to see if Aaron Fox tries to match him against Julian Talbot. Now it's time for the intro.
By Parkour Financial Services, Jonathan Phillips. Quest 27, sponsored by Park Hall Financial Services, Cole Shudra. Quest 28, sponsored by Bradfield Brewery, Lucas Sandstrom. Quest 42, sponsored by IPM, James Batawa. Quest 52, sponsored by LAW, Electrical Doncaster, it's Nikolai Lepchukov! Wearing 63, sponsored by RSH Group, Brendan Connolly! Wearing 75, sponsored by Tilson, it's the Golden Child, Robert Dowd! Wearing 81, sponsored by Northern Ground Care, Ben O'Connor! Where's 88, sponsored by Triple PS, Marco Valorang! Wearing number 90, sponsored by Bradwell Skips, Big John Armstrong! Where's 91, sponsored by the Steelers Sports Bar, Mika Kuka! On a Saturday night in Sheffield, they are your Sheffield window team.
Well, that was quite the raucous welcome here at the Sheffield Arena. Welcome. Saturday night is indeed hockey night, and we're here at the Sheffield Arena for the Sheffield Steelers against the Nottingham Panthers. We've seen them meet four times already in the Challenge Cup. Tonight, it all counts in the league. Delighted to say, alongside me is former Sheffield Steelers captain Ron Shudra. Ron, this is what it's all about, isn't it? This atmosphere, this is what this game means to so many people.
Well, that's for sure. You know, you look at what's going down around us right now, and you got all the intensity in the building, which is exactly the buildup that you want to see and you want to hear from the crowds this year. Entertaining game, I think, is what we've got coming forward.
And we've heard already the reception from Michael Davis. We've heard, obviously, he's reunited with that Valorant and Connolly line tonight. That's been so impressive already this season, that first line. Sheffield, for so many years, had been missing a first line, and that's what they've got now, isn't
it? Well, they do, for sure. You know, you look at the ability that the guys have there to set plays up, put the puck in the back of the net, work for each other as well. So something that that Sheffield may have been missing in the past a lot, but a few years, is guys willing to go that little bit extra mile and play together as a unit. And that's what they've got pretty much all the way through right now. Everyone's playing for each other, and they're trying to do the best they can and being very unselfish and sometimes not selfish enough.
We've talked in the intro about, obviously, the additions of Jake Hansen and Julian Talbot as well. Of course, Joey was such a fan favourite when he was here, and it looks like his younger brother kind of plays almost in his mould.
Well, you know, I haven't seen him play yet live, so we'll see what he does today. We'll have a little talk about it maybe later on in the game, and we'll see what happens. But again, this one's it's going to be a good one, that's for sure. The crowd's into it, nearly a capacity crowd right now, so looking forward to it for sure.
How important is this man on the screen right now, John Armstrong?
Huge,
fantastic,
huge.
In these games.
If he plays the way he can and uses a physical body, that whole line with Lemchikov as well, if they're together, they're fine.
And pause for the national anthem. What an atmosphere, what a game we've got in store. This is it, Sheffield Steelers against the Nottingham Panthers. The starting lines tonight for Sheffield: Thomas Duber in goal, Davey Phillips, Michael Davis, Brendan Connolly, Ben O'Connor and Mark Olivier Valorand. For Nottingham, Kevin Carr in goal, Daniel Fick, Brett Pellini, Jake Hansen, who we've talked so much about, Brian Connolly and Sam Hervey, Nottingham Panthers captain. Ron, what's the talk? What did you used to say before big games like this when all the players are gathering around the goal?
Keep your emotions in check. Don't play on emotion. Play on your skill level and the ability and the things that we've been training against and for this team. They'll have had game tapes. They'll have been watching stuff the last part of the week here. Not just about this game, but about tomorrow's game as well. So they'll know what they need to do. They'll know the systems that Nottingham come back with, whether it's on offense or defense or power play or penalty kill. So it's a matter of who goes out there and keeps those emotions in checks. Everybody knows in the past how emotional Nottingham Sheffield can get. As long as they don't boil over and the game is played, it'll be played back and forward, and it should be an absolute breakneck pace, to be fair.
Well, we're really excited for this one. Fantastic first period of hockey to come up as the players skate around. I haven't mentioned the officials yet. The referees tonight are Dean Smith, Andy Dalton, Danny Beresford and Ryan Fraley are the two linesmen as the players come to centre ice now. And it's Michael Davies against Brett Pellini, and Davies wins the face-off. Comes away with it. Connolly down the right wing, then dumps the puck in. Sheffield go and chase and try and recover. Can they now? Pellini just gets a stick on it. Nottingham. Pellini plays the 1-2. There's the option at the back door. Takes the flick through. It's behind the goal. Davies has it. Brings it out down the right wing. Plays it up the boards to Lemchugov. So good at holding onto the puck. Options to dump it in. It's collected behind the goal by Nottingham. And eventually now they do indeed break out. Forward now to Sam Hurt. Out to the right wing and looking for the return pass, but a good interception there. Sheffield just keeping hold of possession. Dowd plays the cross-ice pass. Of course, Robert Dowd was a bit of a doubt for today's game. And Sheffield have got the early advantage, and it's that man that we've talked about. We gave him the big build-up, and John Armstrong has got it. 53 seconds, and Sheffield take the lead.
Yeah, you look at the good breakout pass there to Lemchugov down the boards, and then right there, Lemchugov gets the puck towards the net. Armstrong all alone for some reason out in front. Sneaks in behind Connolly. No idea how he gets there and so wide open. Maybe it's just on the quick turnaround play from Sheffield from defense to offense that caught. Maybe a line change, but Wallace not happy on the bench. I think he's trying to get some sort of chat with the referee. He's trying to see maybe if there's goalie interference or anything like that. And at the minute, John Armstrong puts Sheffield up 53 seconds into the first period, just like you said. We'll keep an eye on that to see if it's going to go, and it doesn't look like it's going to go to review, so we're straight back at it with a face-off. Big John Armstrong, as you said, the man at the beginning. How important is he? Well, there you go. That's how important he is right off the bat.
And then he wins the face-off. Well, it's a kind of 50-50 face-off in the end, but Sheffield eventually come away with it. Brocklehurst gets it to Dowd, and Dowd again flips it to Lemchugov. Lemchugov with a shot now. And the save is made by Carr. Sheffield keep it and cycle it down. I thought that was going back to Armstrong down low, but Sheffield do a good job of just keeping hold of it. And possession so important in this game. Good interception there from Mika Kuka. And Sheffield come forward now with Lemchugov. Plays a little 1-2, cheeky 1-2 off the boards, and then opts to dump it in behind the net. Kevin Carr has it, but almost a chance out in front there for Dowd, and on the slap shot, Batawa, and a chance in front potentially for Eberle, and another really good shift early on for Sheffield, taking the game to Nottingham.
At the minute so far, yeah, Nottingham had a little bit of a break against Davies' line to start, a little bit of pressure down low, but the last two shifts for Sheffield, some good end-to-end movement, as you saw again there, Robert Dowd getting the puck down in deep. The rest of the Sheffield coming to the cavalry. Lemchugov again across the blue line, does a nice little play to allow that zone entry, and Sheffield take it over again.
Malmquist wins the face-off, but Sheffield steal it back, and a chance. Shot just fist across the face there. Batau recovers, and again, Sheffield straight back on the account, on the attack. Sandstrom sends it forward for Eberle. Eberle, he's got Mellons coming in to help him. Mellon takes over the puck, gets it back to the point. Fast play, fast passing. Batau dumps it off the boards, trying to engineer something out in front. Sandstrom checks hard into the boards. Nottingham trying to get the stick in, trying to free it, but it's Sheffield that keep hold of it with Eberle. Cycles, retains possession. Malland down low. Can he find a man out in front? Opts to go to back to the blue line. Dumps the shot in. Again, Sheffield just cycle, just keeping the puck alive. Here it is with Armstrong looking for an option. So good with that long reach that he has. And Sheffield with an opportunity skating in. The shot is there. Oh, and a chance there for Troncinski. Comes back out to the point, and Nottingham might have an opportunity to break, but it's snuffed out there. Thought for a moment Ollie Betteridge was going to go on a little run. Betauer gets it forward to Armstrong, who dumps it and opts to chase it himself. He's got Daniel Fick to contend with. Sheffield managed to keep it. Cole Shudra now getting an early shift. Armstrong sends the puck in, takes a deflection wide. Again, Sheffield just peppering Kevin Carr at the moment, trying to build the pressure early on. We've only played, coming up on 3 minutes, and it's been neck break as you anticipated, Ron. Coming away with it now, Nottingham through Connolly, but Sheffield don't give them any time on the puck. Win it back and they go again. That top unit is out the Davis Valorand line. And maybe a hold above the play, but the refs let it go. Pellini sends it forward now. Lovely hands there to break through. And a chance for Nottingham, and that's fired wide. Oh, and a breakaway. Here is Valorand breaking forward. Is it Davis actually? Oh. And the chance was just gone. Valorand had an opportunity in. Oh, that's going to be a stinger, isn't it? Brockle here sending the puck in. And Connolly tied up with Daniel Fick behind the net. Refs let it go. Shot early on. And a chance out in front for Sheffield. Can they get the puck? They just doesn't quite sit right. But here it is with Valorand. Turns, shoots. Hits a defenseman's stick, and immediately Connolly's broken up the ice. He's got the sense already that it's a game where anything can happen. Sam Herr trying to get a shot in on Duba, gets the leg pads down. Nottingham now with a spell of possession. Mark Matheson sends it in. Connolly gets it back to Matheson. There's a delayed penalty here coming here for Nottingham. Shot there from Talbot.
It's going to be on Connolly, and it's going to be, it looks like it may be a boarding call that Nottingham player in the corner sold it pretty good. The referee down close, side to side, didn't see anything, but it's back referee that picks it up. In behind Connolly, pretty good sell job there by Nottingham, and that's why Connolly went back at the Nottingham player, telling him exactly what he thought about it.
You can see him gesturing as he went to
the
box.
For sure that it was, and I tend to agree with him from seeing this angle up here, and obviously not the ice level that the referees have, but gotta like the compete battle down behind the Nottingham net. Nottingham defenders, Sheffield forecheckers working hard, trying to get their positioning out in front of the net, trying to gain that battle. We'll see it here.
Is it
Connolly on Connolly? We'll have a little look at it here. Glides in, and it's more of a push, and you can see him launch himself towards the boards. If anything the case there, where that push was on the hip, he's going to bend backwards. He's not going to go flying forwards because it wasn't that much of a pace to it.
I think that's what Dowd's just making the case.
So that's exactly what it is. Obviously, we have
the benefit of
plenty of replays, and that's exactly what it is. So whether the officials are discussing what's going on down there now, we'll have a little look here and see if there is going to be an embellishment on Connolly, but it looks like the linesman's come over to grab a hold of him. Wallace is irate on the bench as well, so we'll see what the calls are, but to me, a 50-50 play like that, and both players, both Connollys are off we go, and we'll see if they have a little chit-chat about that.
And obviously the officials don't always get the credit for calls like that. I mean, early in the game's already got a bit of a fizz and atmosphere to it, so an early call like that, evening it up, kind of makes sense, doesn't it?
I think so. We'll see what the call is here. Cross-checking penalty on Connolly. And a 2 minute for a roughing, so the afters.
So two for cross-checking, two for roughing. We'll see what the other Connolly gets.
2+2 for Connolly by the looks of it.
Yeah. Player coming across the city's Lenchigov.
Embellishment, so there you go. So that's why Connolly went back. So obviously, our benefit of the replay up here and seeing what we could see what it was. And then obviously Connolly's getting the extra two for the bit of the roughing going back after him, I think.
So it is a power play to the Nottingham Panthers. Oh, and a chance already out in front there. An opportunity. Brett Ballmer, the puck failed to. Adam Deutsch back to Ballmer. Back out to the point for Deutsch. They're at the half boards with Ballmer. In such good form recently. Really turned his season around, but Sheffield have a chance. Short-handed. Oh, and Eberle just couldn't find the pass to Jonathan Phillips. You could see what he was trying to do. Play the puck through the defenseman's legs, but it just didn't quite come off for him. Here is Ballmer coming forward there. Lovely hands from him. Wasn't too impressed when the first couple of sightings of him earlier this year. Really didn't impress, but he's really turned his form and his season around. Nottingham now trying to build some pressure, and now it comes out to Ballmer on the near side half boards. Back out to the blue line. Deutsch just exchanging pucks, trying to find the opening. Sheffield collapsing well, and eventually the clearance is made.
A well worked play there by Nottingham, to be fair. They carved it open. They waited for the opportunity with Ballmer and Deutsch on the blue line playing it a little bit of keep away until the space opened up through a seam. Unfortunately, with Pellini, just sort of whiffed on the play, but excellent reads by Sheffield as well in the defensive zone just prior to that.
Kvist brings it forward now, trying to play the drop pass, and Eric Mullen is onto it. Takes it across the red line, across the blue line, circles back, just taking more time off the play. That's smart penalty killing from Eric Mullen. So the puck is dumped in low. Nottingham again. Now there's 8 seconds left on this power play, and it's brought forward now by Hansen. Gave him the big build-up. Oh, and that's a chance, and a great double save there from Thomas Duber. He went forehand, had a shot. He went backhand, had a shot, and twice Thomas Duber denied him.
Yeah, excellent rush there from Hansen. A little bit weak through the defense of Sheffield, although a little bit of a bouncing puck allows him to have that little bit of extra ability. Something just exactly what Lemchikov just did there as well.
Here is Lemchikov. Tries to hand the puck over, and instead Nottingham come away with it. We now skate even strength. And it's sent forward, trying to clear the puck. There's a real battle going on in front of the benches. Valorant profits and comes away with it. He's got one more player to beat. Cycles in front. Matheson now is that player. Opts to go back to the blue line. Shot comes in, just fanned on the shot, and Sheffield could be in trouble here. The breakaway is on, and the shot comes in. Oh, it's wide, and that was a great chance there for Ollie Betteridge.
Yeah, a little bit of a stumble by Ben O'Connor after the shot. A bit of a flutter ball, but Davey Phillips closing the lane down in a hurry, and Thomas Duba way out of his net to cut that angle down. Seeing Phillips come out, and Betteridge rifles one high and wide.
He's an aggressive netminder. We've seen him on penalty shots do that. Come out quickly to close the angle. Oh, Armstrong nearly picks the puck out of the air there and has a chance to shoot on Carr.
Yeah, you'll see Carr come out of the net as well and play the puck. He's done it a couple of times. He just about got caught a few shifts before that, which gave Eberle the chance to pass it out in front. But both netminders are going to keep the play going to the best of their ability, and we'll keep this game going end to end.
Phillips sends it round the boards. Sheffield have a chance to clear, but it takes a deflection and almost lands Steelers defence in trouble. Davey Phillips to Kuka, sent forward now. That's going to come back for icing.
Well, we'll see if it settles down a little bit. A lot of back and forward play, a couple opportunities each way. Nothing really in the chance wise that should be too overrated. The Perlini power play one was probably the best chance realistically about the whole game, to be fair. The way the puck was worked around, everything else, the Armstrong goal was just a fortunate deflection down in front, I think, for him on Carr. So
just got his stick in the lane, didn't he?
And definitely, yes.
Connolly back on the ice, and Davey Phillips is Johnny on the spot to clear it. Almost goes down a blind alley, and in the end Sandstrom just does enough to get it clear, and Sheffield can get a line change. Dowd stays out there to forecheck, just does enough to halt the advances of Connolly, and really hassling and harrying him, but Connolly manages to get it out, and Sheffield were almost in trouble there.
Penalty coming up. Looks like it's going to be Robert Dowd holding penalty behind the play down along the boards. We'll have to see if we have another look at this, but what it means is Sheffield down 0-2 on the power play and penalty kill. We'll see if Nottingham can muster a little bit more than what they did last power play. Sheffield had a couple of good reads through the middle of the house, through middle of the slot. Mellon, Phillips.
They all did it.
We'll have a little look here. If Robert Dowd makes the check on him here, we'll see if he wraps around. He does wrap around right there, just underneath the replay sign. He gets his hand stuck in there between the legs and allows Nottingham the power play chance.
Nottingham hold it in the zone and have a chance to build again. Connolly's the option on the blue line. Hurd now looks for him and now finds him. Just manages to keep it in, gets it back to Sam Hurd, the captain. out wide and back to the blue line for a shot. It comes all the way through DeSantis, but Duba just does enough. Puck takes a deflection off Connolly, and
that'll move the faceoff outside. But and again, another well-worked play from Nottingham. They move the puck east to west, and then they go north to south, and they get the good opportunity for a hard shot. Connolly right here, you'll see. Bring it down and bring it across, and then bring it back for the one-timer, and lots of traffic funneling towards the net.
You see what Sam heard. He was trying to go to the back door, wasn't he?
The way he was,
that
for sure.
Where the empty space was. And Sheffield have got 1:30 left to kill on this power play. Still a pacey first period. He was shocked a bit by the opening pace in the first 5 minutes, and Nottingham kind of raised the bar as Sam Herr crashes hard into the boards under pressure from Davey Phillips. Sent forward now, and Sheffield send it out of the zone and all the way back to Kevin Carr. Nottingham bring it forward now, flip forward for Sam Herr. Sent round. That's going to be stopped by Adam Deutsch. Nottingham just trying to set up the power play at the moment. It's not quite happening for them. DeSantis opts to go back towards the end board. Sheffield get it clear, and that takes a few more pressure seconds. And oh, nearly a chance there. Eberle just kind of chancing his arm, trying to get hold of that loose puck. And again, a bit more precious time. Flicks off that clock for Sheffield. Oh, Eric Milan trying to just interrupt the pass to the back door that Nottingham were trying to get there. Adam Deutsch again sends it in. Coming up on 20 seconds left on this Sheffield power play. And good clearance there from Mika Kuka. Just does the simple things right, doesn't he, Ron?
He does for sure. You know, he's not the flashiest guy in the world. And when you need a defenseman to make a decent play or a good play, he seems to be the one that steps up.
Came with so much experience. That's exactly what Sheffield needed at that point, with bodies falling on the defenseman. Real solo mission there from Nottingham. Brett Bulmer showing fantastic hands as Matheson has it down low, looking for the option out in front. You can see Pellini all alone in front of Duba if they can find him, and they just couldn't find that pass. And the puck goes over the benches and out. So Sheffield Steelers leading this rivalry game, the first meeting between these two sides in the league, by a goal to nil. That early John Armstrong goal, and we just see here again the Brett Bulmer. And the face-off in the neutral zone is won by Nottingham. Connolly gets it back and sent forward. Betauer is the man that's back there. Valorant, little pass to Michael Davis, just threads that top line together for Sheffield. Daniel Fick gets it out in front. Sheffield just hold it in. Pass to Davis. Davis just couldn't pick a body out. Nottingham come away with it with Dylan Malmquist. Oh, and a big hit in neutral ice there, just to throw Malmquist off the puck from Chonsinski. Such a physical player, and we see it again there on the half boards. Sheffield, oh, just trying that stretch pass up to Valorand. Lovely little pass that was. Lapine has it behind the net, has his pass interrupted, and it could fall fortuitously for Nottingham, but Davey Phillips is just so aware. He's had such a good season this year. A great season for Great Britain, and he's just picked up from Kerry play. Dowd with a chance, just flashes over.
Yeah, go back to what you were saying. You've got Kuka, you've got Chonsinski, and you've got Davey Phillips on the back end. As we see right on cue, Chonsinski doing a good job on the step up. Some may have said the puck was gone, it might have been interference, but both players were coming together and the puck was running away from the Nottingham player. But going back to that sort of thing, you've got three pretty solid guys there that know how to play defense first. And that's the big thing. They know how to play defense first. Davey Phillips is never going to be stuck behind the net a la Ben
O'Connor. Oh, and Sheffield have scored! Armstrong won the face-off. It came back to Aaron Brocklehurst, and he just fired. There was a man out in front, I think, that was screening Kevin Carr, and Sheffield have got the ideal start. We'll see it again here. Here is Brocklehurst picking up the puck. Surprised us all with this one. Lovely little shot through the defenseman's legs, and actually it takes a touch out in front.
Off Robert Dowd.
Robert Dowd.
just has the skate there, and again, no call on the play to have a little review. There's no kicking motion whatsoever. Again, a fantastic draw from John Armstrong. Batauer does exactly what he's supposed to do, drop it down the boards, get the shot into the net, pass his first screen. And Robert Dow just putting his body in the way. It doesn't have to be stick or anything else. As long as you're not kicking it, it's a goal off the skate.
Nottingham come forward again, and Duba, and that's the equaliser. Right, Sam Hurst got it. And Sheffield caught napping from the restart. Nottingham got the shot in, and it fell kindly. Duba managed to stretch out the leg pad to deny. We'll see it again here. Fick just skating through the zone, gets the shot off.
It's going to be a shot pass. You can see it's going off the pad, the far side, trying to do exactly that, get back to the middle of the ice. Matheson's the one that nine holes it under the arm. Is can't quite see where Sheffield defenders are as they come back towards the play, and nobody picks up the late guy. Everybody seems to back away and go away from the play, and Nottingham with a great recovery off the next shift to bring it back to 2-1 quickly.
Big goal for Nottingham.
That's how quick the game changes here against these two teams, isn't it? Well, tit for tat.
Immediately, the flow of the game just changes. All that momentum Sheffield got from going two up is almost kind of sapped away, and Nottingham have a chance now here to hold it in. I think Aaron Brocklehurst might have had the chance to make a play, but everyone seemed to be watching the puck. No one seemed to be watching the man, as Sheffield come forward again to create a chance. You can see what Eberle was trying to tee it up for the one-timer, but Sheffield doing a good job of hurrying and harrying, and oh, another hit there from Bettauer. We saw Troncinski making one a few moments ago, and Bettauer raising the physicality. Cross ice pass now for Eberle, little chip ahead. Sandstrom's going to come in to help, but Nottingham bypass and might be able to get it clear up the ice. High looping passes brought down by Nottingham.
We're going to get a late hit. Oh, we're going to get a charge. Yeah, Andy Dalton, I don't know about that one on a charge, to be fair. Maybe a little bit late, but we'll see if he's accelerating towards, if his feet are moving, or if he jumps. We'll see. No foot movement.
Puck's gone, isn't it?
Yeah, puck's gone, so that's maybe a late hit, but his feet aren't moving. He's gliding into it. He doesn't look as though he's leaping to concentrate or to be called a charge if you go by the rules. Possibly a late hit, but in a game like this, from what we've seen so far, that's a pretty dodgy one in my eyes.
Certainly been an increase in physicality. Going back, we saw the hit from Troncinski and then Bettauer. Sandstrom just trying to do what he does. And Sheffield have an opportunity on the penalty kill. Jonathan Phillips using his speed. Bringing it forward now. Nottingham can't get the breakaway with DeSantis. Nottingham weaving to try and find some space. Send the puck in on Duba. Duba plays it in the end and gets it back out to Armstrong. A risky play, but it works on this occasion for the Steelers.
I think he was trying to do a little bit more than what ended up. I think he didn't think he had as much time, or he thought he had a little bit more time, and actually kind of woofs on it a little bit, but John Armstrong being in the right spot.
Johnny,
the puck
the
comes
spot
to him, and he makes the rest of the play, or that was right back down his throat.
So Hansen sends it round the boards, but it comes here for Mullins. Mullins with a chance, feeds it through. Oh, almost a chance there for Eberle. Eberle keeps it alive behind the net, but Nottingham arrived to rescue the situation and bring it away. This time with Hansen. And you forget, Nottingham are the ones on a power play with 1:05 left to play. So three power plays for the Panthers already in this game, and the one goal they've scored has been an even strength run. Caught the Steelers napping from the restart. Connolly brings it forward, dump pass to Matheson. Matheson brings it over the blue line, checks hard into the boards. Armstrong just tries to free the puck, comes back to the blue line. Nottingham looking for the shot and has his pocket picked. Sheffield break away with it now, and a ferocious shot coming in from the point.
Yeah, Ben O'Connor reading the play down the boards that Nottingham was trying to do. and exploited as best he could without a good hard shot from the wing.
Altuba might be in trouble now as the puck comes all the way through for Tolbert, but again Sheffield have got it, and again it's a breakaway, this time for Valorant. Can he find Connolly? He can't. It's tied up on the boards.
Wow, if it's a hold on Robert Dowd, that was a lot more of a hold there on the Nottingham player right in front of the officials.
And Sheffield kill off the penalty. Back to full strength as Sandstrom makes his return. So three power play opportunities for Nottingham. Chance for Bettridge in the corner, trying to backhanded flick it in front of Duba's net. Connolly goes down. Now gets it free to Valorant. Valorant looking for the return to Connolly. Good control by him. Oh, tried to flick it back out in front, but just couldn't quite find his man. Malmquist comes away with it, trying to jam it short side on Duba, but he makes the save. Comes back out in front, takes a deflection off a Steelers defenseman, and they're going to recycle it. Malmquist picks it up. It's down low. Played off the end boards and tried to get it back to Malmquist. Here it is for Connolly. Connolly sends it low on Duba, but the rebound is dealt with by Betauer. Flip forward and Sheffield will get a line change. 2:37 remaining in this first period. It's been breathless stuff from both sides as Dowd gets a stick in there and wins the puck back again. And that's going to be called a hold. Ironic cheers from the Sheffield fans there.
He wasn't going to call it at first, if you watch. It took Robert Dowd three or four strides with his arm behind him before he ends up getting called. It's Fick. Watch here, right here. So right now he's got a hold of the arm. Now it's one, two, three, and he actually stops Robert Dowd in his tracks. So no shake of the head there, and straight to the penalty box for two.
So with 2:26 remaining in the first, Sheffield have got their first power play, and we see John Armstrong coming to the face-off circle. And of course, for the second goal, Armstrong won the face-off. We talked about his face-off percentages, 56% coming in tonight. He's won 298 in total this year. That's the most in the Elite League. So important to get Sheffield going on the front foot on the special teams. O'Connor has it in the corner. Nottingham intercept and bring it forward now. There's an opportunity for Sam Herr.
Such a deceptive skate of Sam Herr. It doesn't look like he's moving, and all of a sudden he takes an extra half push or a stride, and he
it's
explodes
like he's skating
out.
Downhill, doesn't it?
Sometimes it does. He's very, very smooth in transition, and how he gets his legs back underneath them, and he's very, very deceptive from a half pace to three to full.
O'Connor assessing his options, gets it forward to Lem Tugoff. Tried to play the pass in, but wasn't quite on the same page with his line mate. O'Connor now has it. Well, look up ice with 72 seconds remaining. Dowd has it. Plays it off the end boards. Here it is now on the far-hand side again. We'll be looking for Robert Dowd on that one-timer. Here it comes in. Dowd creeps in front of the net. And it was Brocklehurst with the shot, and it just took a deflection out in front. Lem Tugoff was the player there trying to get the deflection, and we saw it work for Armstrong trying the same thing again.
Yeah, you see John Armstrong controlling it again. Nice sauce pass cross ice is Trutzinski. It gets a good one-timer across. A bit of a flutter ball, and it doesn't actually make it through to Carr, so you're absolutely right. Lemchugov down in front gets a little bit too much of that fluttering puck, and it goes up just into the crowd or just into the netting in behind.
Connolly tied up at the face-off circle, but he comes away with it, gets it back. Here it is for Valorant. Valorant back to the blue line. Here is Valorant back in front, and Matheson just trying to skate his way out of trouble, but there's three Steelers players there to try and pick his pocket. Comes back to the Steelers on the blue line. And the half boards looking for an opportunity. And they jam it home. Comes now for Sandstrom. There's a player out in front, but it deflects the wrong way off the player. Back to the blue line, and winding up is Aaron Brocklehurst. Back here for Valorant. Oh, just couldn't quite control the puck at that point. Fakes the stick handle and comes back in, works himself an opening. Connolly loses out down low, and Lapine manages to clear, but only as far as Brocklehurst. Sheffield doing a good job of keeping the pressure on as the power play expires. Sandstrom has a chance, it loops up, and almost a chance there for Connolly. It was a hopeless hack at the, or hopeful rather, hack at the puck. And it just sent the way of Kevin Carr. Now Sheffield bringing it forward again as time expires. We've got 5 seconds remaining in the first. Can Sheffield get another goal here? There's a scramble in front of the net and they'll be denied. Fantastic opening first period from the Sheffield Steelers. They look, lead 2-1.
If you actually look at it, Sheffield had 6 players on the ice there just near the end. So we'll see what happened. If there's a bit of a mix-up, but Eberle coming off the bench and another deflection through Carr does an excellent job on Jonathan Phillips fighting that off, and Mellon the whistle had gone there, but I'm sure if we get a little bit of a wider pan angle on that, we may just see that Sheffield snuck away with 6 players out on the ice.
So the Sheffield Steelers are 2-1 up at the end of this. So let's have a look back at the first period, Ron, as we look here. First period action, it was really breathless, and this is the first goal for John Armstrong, sent forward towards the net, and Armstrong just gets his stick in the lane and deflects it past Carr.
Yeah, it's a good pass east to her, north and south, but right there it takes a deflection off the linesman, which allows Lemchikov to quickly gather it in. Hard to tell what part of the body that goes off of Armstrong. He's right in and around Carr, whether it's a deflection that goes up and over, but nice heel-to-heel turn. Lemchikov's head up all the way, and you can see good hard shot through, and it is. It's right there. You see John Armstrong right there underneath. So I think it goes 5-hole and then sort of bobbles up as it goes behind the netminder as he takes a lot of the pace off it. But Armstrong does what a goal scorer is supposed to do and drive the net hard, and that's the play that happens. And here you see the other opportunity coming through, which bravely blocked by
someone.
Yeah, but again, Nottingham allowed a couple of times. Hansen went through, I think Bulmer went through a little bit. Sheffield maybe backing off, maybe not expecting to be that much speed going through. And this was a block shot in the Ollie Betteridge opportunity as Phillips closes in a hurry as that flashes up and over. But Duba, you know, 6 feet outside. Big hit from Tronzinski and Malmquist here.
We've seen again the physicality throughout this game, haven't we?
Yeah,
there's
been some back and forward stuff, but here's Big John on the.
This is the second goal.
The second goal, and
it comes in.
Yeah, and it's a bit fortunate goal, but Robert Dowd again does what he's supposed to do. The set play is what it is. You can see Lemchikov way out the back, so it's a set play where the defenseman drives down and maybe looks for Lemchikov coming up the top, but he must have seen something with Robert Dowd, and just snaps it towards the net. And Robert Dowd here, right like a freight train, just attacks the net.
And that's what you get from winning clean face-offs, doesn't it?
For sure. You see Brocklehurst doing the right thing. He actually shoots at 5-hole, and a good fortune it goes through. But Robert Dowd, he doesn't do anything other than just have his skate where it should be, and that deflects up and over the net. And then right from the get-go, missed assignments. Right there you can see 2 Sheffield players coming in way late, 3 going to the net. Nobody picking up Matheson coming in late. Because I think it's Kuka that tries to step up there and gets danced. And then it's just Perlini going to the net. Brocklehurst turning the wrong way. Dowd not turning the right way. The other defenseman, John Armstrong, behind the net. You can see here, there's the shot. There's the rebound coming out. And it's 1, 2, 3 Nottingham players that we see. And 3 Sheffield players not anywhere near where they should have been.
So then this is the hit on Sandstrom, the late hit that we saw on Betteridge.
Yeah, it gets called as a charge, but yeah, like I said, if anything, maybe a late hit, because you can see Ollie Betteridge takes the puck away, and it's a good half a second at least behind. And then Armstrong here to Tronzinski on a one-timer. Another good save. I think this was the one that goes off of Lemchikov out in front. So an excellent period, to be fair, for both teams. Some good opportunities, some good goal-scoring chances, a couple of decent hits. Power play chances left and right, so.
So we're just waiting for the Steelers to come back out for the start of the second period. Nottingham have taken the opportunity to come out a little bit early, and let's have a look at some of the other scores around the league. Cardiff are trailing 2-0 to the Belfast Giants. The Dundee Stars are 2-1 up over the Coventry Blaze. It's 0-0 Glasgow-Guildford. Obviously our featured game here, Sheffield are leading Nottingham by 2-1, and it's the 5 Flyers that are trailing by 1-0 against Manchester. That one's still in the first period, 15 minutes played. So here come the Sheffield Steelers for the start of the second period, and Ron, we're having a little sift through. It's amazing now the stats that they're able to give us. But kind of between the periods, we were looking at all kinds of things, face-off win percentages, where the shots are happening. But actually, the shots are pretty even at 9 apiece. And you have to say that although it seems fairly even, you've got to remember that Nottingham have already had 3 power plays.
Yeah, that's the equaliser right there. Sheffield obviously having to kill penalties and Nottingham maybe getting a few on the power play. But to be fair, Sheffield's done a pretty good job keeping it pretty tight. They didn't have an awful lot of real good quality chances on the power play. They had, like I said, the one, the Perlini one where he kind of woofed on it a little bit, was well worked. A shot from the blue line. Sheffield have closed it down fairly quickly. So again, the 9-9 is pretty much what the period was. If you looked at how it went back and forth, faceoffs, I think we're about 50-50s in each other's zone. Obviously, in your own zone, you want to be a bit more. You want to probably be 70-30 in your own zone. But both teams were 50-50 in the end zone. So given that opportunity both ways, they've had some chances off faceoffs. Sheffield obviously scored on one, and that leads us into the start of the second period.
At the end of the day, the score that matters is the score on the board, and it's the Steelers that are leading by 2-1. So we've got a bit of a false start at the start, so we'll come back for the
I wonder if Davies is going to get credit for that as we reset back to 20, so I don't think so.
And this time Davies does win the face-off, so that will work in his favour in terms of his statistics going forward. And we puck is dumped in and Connolly will chase. It'll come back out.
Funny bounce off the boards. Yeah, difficult bounce off the boards there for the Nottingham defenseman to read.
You could see Hansen was almost reading it like he was going to get it, and a pass through the neutral zone. Meanwhile, Sheffield can reset in their own zone. Perlini dumps it into the zone. Nottingham use it as an opportunity to change lines. On comes Julian Talbot, his line. Meanwhile, Sheffield have got it behind their own net, looking to set up the breakout. Malmquist is there, just putting a little bit of pressure on, and in the end, Sheffield off to dump it out and almost catches out Kevin Carr. And we've seen some quick goals from situations that you wouldn't expect. It's not that Sheffield have been able to set up or necessary. They've been quick fire goals.
Ben O'Connor, I think, is going to get credit for a shot on goal from his own, behind his own goal line. I was going to say, if that would have been a fantastic goal for an empty net the way he did it. Having a little giggle, is that what you're going to point out?
You can see that's what Betauer and Davy Phillips are probably saying to him right there. Little look over the shoulder. Meanwhile, we come back for a neutral zone face-off, and John Armstrong wins one in the neutral zone. Puck is dumped in, and on the far-hand side, Sheffield will go and chase and will recover the puck through Dowd. Lemtugov spins with almost no space, and Armstrong has it now. Such a good combination, Armstrong and Lemtugov this year. Of course, they were teammates in Medvedev, and they've carried on their chemistry now here in Sheffield. Nottingham bring it forward, across the red line, across the blue line, dump it in. We'll go and chase, and a big hit coming on there in the corner. Brocklehurst on Matheson. Now Sheffield come away with it, but Brocklehurst has his pocket pinched. And now Dowd, one defenceman to beat in front of him, tried to work it to the high slot, and Nottingham defenceman just got a stick in the lane. Deutsch. Not in clear, and Betauer will gather, reset, bring it out. Pass into the neutral zone, and now Sheffield go back to come forward. Here it is through Eberle. Eberle with a shot on goal. Carr can't hold it. Gathers it the second time of asking.
Yeah, again, a good start to the period, back and forward. Obviously, the O'Connor is the only shot on net that's of any consequence. So far from behind his net, that's the only talking point. But again, some good heads-up play. Mark Matheson tries to go for a little offensive foray into the Sheffield zone. They're allowed to walk in as, again,
Eberle wins the offensive face-off. It comes back for Sandstrom, a shot there, and it's Mellon that gathers behind the net. Backhanded, tries to get it back to the blue line, and in the end, Nottingham managed to break out with Roll. And comes through to Kevin Carr, and moves it off to DeSantis. It's not quite as frenetic as that first period run. It's kind of settled down a bit now into
Yeah, a little choppy to go forward here. No one's really put their stamp on it like they did the first sort of period. You're always going to see that as the game goes. Someone's going to try to come out way quicker than the other team. And Sheffield did for the first part, but settling down into a groove here, trying to get roll all three, four lines for both sides and allowing some good play to interchange.
No, Sheffield give it away, but Nottingham, in trying to work it back to the blue line, end up going all the way back to Kevin Carr. What a pass from Kevin Carr into Sam Herr. Herr forward now. Centre saucer pass through the crease and just couldn't get the touch out in front. Here's a chance for Armstrong using his big reach to send it away and just a little flick shot on Kevin Carr. He does enough to deny him. O'Connor. Can Sheffield recover? They can now with Phillips. Phillips. It's a 360, Coop 360, and has another opportunity. Half of the fans up there in front of us in the stands were on their feet. They thought that was a goal.
Yeah, I think it's hard to see if it's Phillips or Sandstrom. I think it was Sandstrom that got two bites as he goes to the bench. You can see the frustration as he had a nice little mouth word as he came in. But good work from Sheffield. Some good pressure building now with O'Connor now getting a shot raining through.
The message has definitely been from Aaron Fox. Shots on net, shots on net. That's what Sheffield need is they come forward now. Pellini with a great pass there looking for her. But it's counter-attack hockey. Forward comes Cole Shudra. Just squeezed out on the half boards. Still there for him. Hansen. Sheffield recovering the neutral zone. And forward comes Michael Davies. Plays it off the boards and Sheffield retain possession. It's back here with Connolly. Ferocious pass there from Connolly to Davis. Davis just does enough to help it onto the blue line. Shot comes in.
Excellent shift there for Sheffield's so-called fourth line with Phillips and Shudra. And Armstrong was in the middle of that. And obviously Davies comes out. But here's the save from Sandstrom. Second chance coming right there. Oh. And what a fantastic sprawling split save by Carr. You can see Sandstrom just about gets it through, and you can see why the frustration that he was on the bench when he come through 2 or 3 inches higher, and that's up and over the pad. But fantastic work by Carr, never giving up and battling the way he did to make sure that he made that save.
They've had some chances early on in this game, and it's been end to end in start this second period, but we've come all the way back for a face off, and so frustrating there. We can see Aaron Johnson sat there on the Steelers bench.
Everybody's booing at the dance cam. The five guys, there's no one's actually dancing. The three or four girls on the screen just didn't bother, I think.
Connolly gets it back to Valorand. Valorand just works a pass out of absolute nothing. Such an awkward position. Just gets it back. Davis sends it out in front. Oh, and a chance there. Sheffield out in front, but it's still there. And Valorant.
Yeah, Valorant. And this line again with Valorant, Davies, and Connolly there just about cash in as we see Lapine coming in to try to clear house. But this puck goes off. I think it's is it Matheson out in front right there off his inside. Watch this hit the post right there as Carr can't quite get to it. And then Valorant walks around. And Carr again uses that little bit of toe that he has. And Nottingham to the rescue coming in to help him out.
And Lakovic and Valorant clashing after the play.
Yeah, usually the boos in the building here are saved for the opposition team, especially when Nottingham roll into town. But to have the five guys booed for not dancing is something original for me.
Certainly is. Sheffield will have an opportunity with Bettridge facing off against Armstrong. Armstrong wins that particular battle. Chonsinski skates around, looks to work the shot on his backhand. Betau did a good job to keep it in the zone. Sends it forward and it comes crashing back off the plexi. Dowd frees it for Armstrong. Armstrong working there away to get it clear. Betteridge has it. Malmquist, lovely little...
And a hooking penalty coming up on the back check. It looks as though it's going to be Trunczynski who gets caught chasing down Betteridge. Happens all down in the neutral zone. He does a good job trying to back check, and it just gets his hands, or is it Lemchigov? Which one is it?
It's Lemchigov.
Lemchigov it is, yeah. He gets his stick up in on the hands, and that's going to be called pretty much 99% of the time. The back check was there, but that little bit of a hook is what gets called.
So a fourth power play for Nottingham Panthers in this game. We're not midway through the second period yet. Nottingham win the face-off, but not cleanly. It comes back out to the blue line. Here it is with Mark Matheson. Matheson using his skating ability to try and work some room. Back there for the one-timer. Duba, great save, and they put the rebound in. It's Brett Pellini that's got it. And Nottingham tie up this game on the power play.
Yeah, it was bound to happen sooner or later with the opportunities that they've had. Nice little play across here. And again, the slap shot coming in going far side. Perlini's is Johnny on the spot as Duba makes a fantastic toe save with traffic out in front. But nobody can get back to Perlini as he sort of just bats it on the back end. Jonathan Phillips, Eberle and Villa and the other Davey Phillips can't do anything about it. They keep that puck going out of the net. So a penalty through the neutral zone on Lemchikov. Not the best penalty, not an action penalty, more of a reaction penalty coming back on the back check. Allows Nottingham back into this game, 2-2. Just over 14 minutes left to play second period, and we're all back even.
Goal timed at 25:43, and it's all tied up here in Sheffield. A real back and forward game. Sheffield jumping out to a 2-0 lead through Armstrong and Dowd. And then Jay Canton, a shot. Just got a rebound there. There's Nottingham.
It looks like Sheffield's going to go on a power play here. Yeah, you can see it's Quist on Kuka, and then he has a little bit of a swing with a stick up near the eyes as they go down. It's hard to pick up the replay there, as if we only just see the end of it. Maybe a little bit more, we would have seen if there's a bit more contact. So tough for us to comment on that one a little bit. I know there was a bit of a one-on-one battle as they went through, and Kvist seems to be the one that was the aggressor through the call in the eyes of the official.
So Connolly will take the face-off here, or he was going to take the face-off. Just got a break in play. Kvist in the box. And Connolly wins the face-off there, gets it back to the blue line, but Brocklehurst can't keep it in the zone. Opts to go back behind Duba's net and reset. So Sheffield Steelers with their second power play opportunity of the game.
And it's going so far the same way the first one did, to be fair. Very, very disjointed forwards, in my eyes, not helping off an awful lot to get back. But that's the system that Aaron Fox wants to play. Stretch it out a bit and see if they can make the play.
Connolly holds it in the zone, and Valorand almost managed to poke it through the defenseman's legs. Duba back to Brocklehurst, and all the play in the wrong end of the ice for the Sheffield Steelers at the moment. Brocklehurst brings it forward. Here it is with Valorand. Can he work a shot? Can he work an opportunity? He had maybe a chance to offload it to Connolly. Again, Nottingham clear. It's back with Duba. Duba with a nice pass out to the blue line. Dowd takes over. Troncinski now over the red line. Stick handles past Lakovic, and he's checked into the boards by Deutsch for his troubles. Sheffield trying to win the puck back, but again it's Nottingham who clear all the way down the ice. Duba just holds the puck, and O'Connor's the man to bring it out. North-south skating from Ben O'Connor as he looks to go back to the net and almost works an opportunity out in front, but Kevin Carr just holds on to it again.
Yeah, another good job there as you see Kelsall and Lakovic out on the penalty kill for Nottingham. Good to see the one youngster, I can say. Lakovic has been around a long time, but Armstrong does a good job. And O'Connor tries to control this, but he doesn't get anything on the back end. Matheson doing a good job. Carr doing an excellent job as well, trying to stay as big as he can. Although he went down way, way early to take away the lower part of the net. But again, Sheffield need a little bit more.
Good win from Armstrong. Gets it back to Kuka. Shot comes in there, and Armstrong almost profits. Again, being the man out in front. Troncinski forced to go back into the neutral zone. Backhanded pass. Dowd now sends it towards the hash marks. Where's this puck going to come down? Fortuitous bounce there for the Sheffield Steelers, but there's still an opportunity here for the Nottingham Panthers, and that's a goal for Brett Bulmer. Shorthanded goal. And they're the most frustrating goals. The Sheffield Steelers 2, the Nottingham Panthers 3.
Well, it is, especially when you look at what Sheffield has on the power play. They should be angry. They've had absolutely nothing on the power play. Like I said, they're very, very stretched, and no trouble whatsoever. Dubé goes for a poke check there as he goes around O'Connor. O'Connor can't do an awful lot with Balmer making the power move to the net. Balmer with a nice little quick hands. Dubé goes for the power for the poke check. As soon as he misses with that poke check, you know he's got a wide open net, and Balmer's not going to miss an awful lot of those. As Sheffield now down 3-2, and the idea has got to start coming in fairly quick for them.
Certainly been Nottingham's period with the power play goal from Brett Pellini, and then short-handed goal there for Brett Balmer. What have Sheffield got in the locker to bring it back? Well, they're on a 2-on-1 here now. As Nottingham come forward, Hansen with the shot. Dubé just does enough. A little Milan goes to ground after the play. Sam Herr has it for Nottingham. Cuts inside, hands it off to Pellini. Pellini can't work the shot, and now he does. He finds the top corner. Brett Pellini has his second of the game. Yeah, and it's the Sheffield Steelers 2, the Nottingham Panthers 4.
Yeah, Aaron Fox is incensed on the bench. Where was the call on Milan? On Mellon, sorry. And realistically, that play happened a long time ago. It's the Sheffield defenseman just get carved. The defense right here, inside out. And Hurd slides it along. There you see Mellon go down, but it's a wrist shot going back the other way. And if it's me on the bench, I'm calling a timeout to rally these troops back together.
You can see Aaron Fox.
Aaron Fox is remonstrating pretty good with what's why isn't the call, but at the end of the day, Nottingham have just scored in quick fire, throwing Sheffield way on the back foot. So we'll see who steps up and if anything can be made to go the other way.
Now the Steelers bench calling for a penalty there on Connolly.
And again, to be fair, from up here, it's not a penalty in my eyes, but then I'm not the one, I guess.
Sheffield hold it into the zone as the Sheffield Arena comes alive now, trying to get their team motivated. Nottingham have an opportunity, 3-on-2. Fenton's lost his sticks, and Sheffield are down to four men just for a very brief moment. Hansen back out to the blue line for Matheson. Nottingham building something here now. Dubé, hold on, holds on to that one. Or did that go over? I lost sight of the puck when it shot.
Yeah, Dubé ended up getting hold of it in the glove. You'll see it come floating through. I think it's Lapine that just floats one through. It gets it past Valorant. It might have just touched him there, but Dubé, yeah, nice job out in front of the net as well by Davies, boxing out, not allowing any opportunity to come back through. But Sheffield need to put the momentum on the other foot. They're in the second battle here. They're not in the first to every puck. They're second to everything, and Nottingham are just attacking nicely.
Aaron Fox, a little cursory glance at the scoreboard, but still time here. Time maybe for Nottingham, a chance at the back door for Bettridge.
Sheffield very fortunate there. Yeah, John Armstrong with a big, big stick swing. Nottingham's not done yet.
And Sheffield get it to Lemchugov. What can Lemchugov? Rips one just wide. Thought for a moment that was going to nettle right in the top corner. Got a rocket of a shot when he unleashes it. Betao, stretch past the Dowd, backhand, saved. Just gone end to end at the moment. Betao sent forward. Sandstrom's the man in the middle. Can he find him? He doesn't find him, he finds Eberle instead. And that energy line is just getting Sheffield going at the moment. Sheffield player steps up in the play. Betao. Crucial stick there from Troncinski. Nottingham cycle the puck now. Quist with a one-timer. Blocker saved by Dubé. Back out, recycled. Quist again. Little wrist shot. Now it's banked off the boards and cleared. Will it fall for Eberle? It doesn't. And Nottingham recycle it with Talbot. Talbot brings it forward, but Tower just gets a stick on it, and it's over the benches and out.
Yeah, and you have a little bit of a breather for that, but Carr is the man of the hour at the minute. This one here, I think, this goes wide as a rolling puck. Might have got just a little bit of that as it rolls by. Might have been going wide as it was, but coming back, Robert Dowd has a good opportunity through the middle of the ice, and Carr makes a nice little fight save off the sort of left shoulder.
Sandstrom is almost a chance out there in front for Steelers. Now it's Nottingham that come away with it. Shot there coming in. Duba just doing enough at the moment. Nottingham again doing a good job of just recycling the puck. It comes back to Roll out here to Hansen. Hansen with a deft little pass, just trying to find the man at the back door. DeSantis battling on the boards, and Pellini looking for the hat trick, just sends the puck on goal. Davey Phillips Eberle trying to win it back, and maybe an opportunity of Sheffield, but it's too slow, and Balloran line comes onto the ice just slightly behind Eric Mellon. That opportunity, there's a little bit more pace on the pass, maybe he could have made something of it. 7:45 remaining in the second period, and it's absolutely flown by. First period was absolutely breathless, and not had too many stoppages in the second, just for the penalty. Pellini, of course, tied it up on the power play, and Bormer had the short-handed goal, and then Pellini with his second. So it's been a three-goal swing for Nottingham in this second. Sheffield have to find a response. Duba, again, out of his crease to play the puck. It's off the boards, and it's in the corner. Brocklehurst. It's back behind the net. Kuka loses out in that battle, and Sheffield just aren't winning the little battles at the moment. Matheson back to the blue line, building, and that puck deflects high into the netting. And that seems to be the story of how the second period's kind of gone at the moment, Ron. It's Sheffield are just losing those tiny little battles, maybe a couple of face-offs, those 50-50s behind the net.
Yeah, well, this is what it is. You know, they're getting out-battled one-on-one. They're not getting to the loose pucks like they were in the first period. They're using their speed and their pace, but Nottingham got their legs woken up into the second period. So they're the ones that are getting the advantage, power play and a shorthanded goal, to be fair, which have pushed them ahead. But Sheffield need to find some sort of fight back. They need to get in there and get in on top of Carr. They've had the opportunities. Eberle and both and Dowd have had the good opportunities, but Carr's been equal to the task so far. So, again, we need a little bit more. A little bit more traffic and a little bit more getting that puck to the net.
Dowd with a chance, but it comes off of Nottingham. Now sent forward Nottingham, another chance and an opportunity for Julian Talbot there. Sent forward, and Sheffield do a good job of just pouncing on the loose puck. Lemchugov, can he find a man in orange? He's in the corner working away with a man at his back. Out in front, he does find a man now. Batao with a chance. Oh, he almost had a second chance of it as well. Oh, and a shot there, and it's come off a Nottingham defenseman's visor, I think that was
Ollie Bettridge. Yeah, he takes that one up high, but
now it's sent forward, and Nottingham have an opportunity. It's Talbot, but he just chooses to hold on to the puck. Does almost a Nikolai Lemchugov, and circles back around and keeps possession of the puck. Davey Phillips now for the Steelers as we enter the final 6 minutes of the second period. Steelers 2, Nottingham 4. Eberle with it, trying to play that deft little shot pass off the pads of Kevin Carr. Again, Nottingham come away with it. Their tails up at the moment, and this might be an opportunity for Sheffield. It's a 3-on-1 if they can play it right. Sandstrom cuts in, tries to work the chance. It's back in the slot. Eberle had the shot. Here it is. O'Connor has two bites at it. Sandstrom loses out on the battle on the boards. Now Nottingham come forward and are just out of reach for Jake Hansen. He's got a man at his back. And Brocklehurst. Now Sheffield have an opportunity. 2-on-1. Nottingham defenseman just manages to get back.
Yeah, Lapine doing a great job on the back check. He's kind of got his pocket picked a little bit by Trocinski, but some good acceleration for the big man to get back there to do what he needed to do. Better passage of play there for Sheffield. A couple of good opportunities. Eberle and Sandstrom linking up very, very well. And again, Carr does an excellent job. as you can see Bettauer come in here, comes inside now. Why is this Nottingham defenseman backed off so far?
It's a great little dangle, isn't it?
Yeah, one-on-one. Not sure he wants to have that one back and go right top shelf with that. He tries to go sort of just over the pad, but you're in that tight, you just flip the wrist and zip it top shelf. Easy to say from up here.
Good save there from Kevin Carr as Sheffield just kind of recycle it, keep it in the zone. It's sent out in front. There's some traffic there, and that's the goal. Sheffield have got one back. It's Marco Valorant.
Yeah, Duca does a good job getting the puck to the net. It bounces through. Valorant, Johnny on the spot, bounces it out of here. You can see that puck's going through here. Hits
DeSantis
on the back. DeSantis on the backside, and here it pops right up here. Goes up and over the back right there. Carr can't quite get it as he's not quite on the post. Valorant puts it from a horrendous angle, basically around along the side of the goal line. And Dalloran gets to celebrate with 4.5 minutes left to go second period. Nottingham still with that shorthanded marker taking the lead 4-3. But it had to come with the opportunities that Nottingham had allowed on Carr. Carr made some fantastic saves. And finally he's beaten on one.
Sheffield have half the deficit. They bring it back to a 4-3 deficit. Marco Valorant with his 11th of the year. Mika Kuka getting an opportunity, but Nottingham now come forward and Ollie Betridge might have a chance. And that's what we saw in the first period. It was just after Sheffield had got their second. Nottingham came straight back and 16 seconds later it was in the back of their net. Just have to watch against that as they're pushing so hard to get this equaliser. Trondzinski now unleashes his rocket of a shot, but it comes off a Nottingham defenceman and has to go and collect the puck from Duba.
Referee's blowing the whistle as he didn't see that it, where it went. Well, when Trondzinski meant to dump the puck in hard, it actually bounces off the Nottingham defenseman in the way and goes all the way back down to Duba. The referee in the Nottingham zone had totally lost possession or lost sight of the puck, so this is why we're going to end up thinking it should be that center ice, to be fair, for the restart.
I think that's what Lentugov and Armstrong are just making the points over the moment.
It is, because it's an oopsie by the official, so they're taking it out of the Sheffield zone into neutral ice.
Talbot gets the better of John Armstrong on that occasion. Inside the face-off dot. Armstrong has it back now. Sheffield can build on the right-hand side. Behind the net, Daniel Fick. And a Sheffield player throwing a late... Not sure if it was a late hit, but... missed on his hit. Lentugov keeps possession. One hand on the stick. It's so impressive when he does that. Bettauer back to Lentugov, the man that started the attack. Just can't quite get up and over his man. And that's going to be a penalty. High sticks.
Yes, high stick it is. Ballmer's great over to argue the case. But Lentugov tries to do the dangle inside and right. Well, it was just before that, to be fair. The stick goes up and you can see Lentugov. The stick went absolutely flying before that gets into the corner.
That's Daniel Fick who's heading to the box. So an opportunity for Sheffield to tie it up with 3:23 remaining in the second.
Yeah, Sheffield need to be better. They need to be a lot better, as we'll see it here. The toe drag comes through as it goes up and over. Lemchikov kind of grabs, and right there goes the stick with a high stick, and that's why it's called, as it goes up and out of play. But as I said, Sheffield got to be better. Better retrieval, better organization on the power play here. We'll see if it starts from this face-off win.
Davis goes down low. They try to work it back out in front, but there's no man there to put it away. Kept back in by Trondzinski. Worked back out to the blue line for Brocklehurst. Back here for Davis. Can't quite work the shot. And there's a stick in there. Just dispossesses Davis. But here's Sandstrom. Sandstrom on the backhand. Comes back out to Valorant. It's deflected in and out.
Excellent play out in front. I think it's Ollie Betteridge down on the ice. See the flash of the blue stick, which kind of catches my eye, which makes it him, and it is Ollie Betridge right here. Desperation, as you can see. Valorant dives in, gets the opportunity in there, right there. Excellent, not
what
giving up on a puck
is.
Again by Betridge to deny that shot to go up into the crowd. But again, Davies loses control on the boards. There is an option, he doesn't make it. He tries to over stick handle. Sandstrom tries to walk through the middle of the ice. The puck gets knocked off and luckily goes out to Valorant. So maybe they're just trying to do a little bit too much one-on-one stuff and not moving the puck quickly enough as Nottingham are closing him down.
Davis now with a chance, looking for a man out in front. Again, Connolly maybe had the opportunity to shoot and didn't.
Well, and again,
the refs lose sight of it. whistle it dead.
Yeah. It's tough to lose sight of it when everybody looks and you see four or five players look up into the black curtain. And unfortunately, it's the player out in front that he gets chested down and goes out. So now the referees are going to go, you know, where's that play going to be? The puck was actually outside the blue line anyways. So the right call should be where it is at the minute.
Same face off.
Yeah, exactly where it should be.
So 1:15 remaining on this Steelers power play, only their second power play of the game.
Good to see that. Sorry to cut you off. Good to see that Wallace has confidence in the young guys. Kelsall's out there on the penalty kill.
One thing Tim Wallace has done is give the youngsters plenty of opportunities.
Yeah, they're doing well. You know, you got Lakovic and Kelsall out there killing the penalties, and not to mention Ollie Betteridge as well.
Nottingham player's lost his head. I think it's Lapine. He skates hard to the bench, and on comes. Oh, and just fanned on the shot, Davis. Couldn't quite connect. Brocklehurst looking for Davis again, and a chance for Connolly out in front. Works it back to Davis on the face-off. Back for Brocklehurst. Hits a Nottingham defenseman. Davis collects. Back to the blue line. Brocklehurst. Just a Nottingham body in the way, and it's flick clear. I think it's Lakovic. Managed to get that.
Lakovic clears it. Kelsall blocks the shot, so the two British guys up front doing an excellent job.
Chonskinski skates forward. Dumps it off. Yep. Not quite on the same page, Sheffield, at the moment. Here is Dowd. What can he do on the wraparound? Trying to work the opening. Back to O'Connor. Armstrong just fanned on the shot a little bit. DeSantis will bring it away. Beats one and Nottingham out the box, and Sheffield has so many times you see a man come out the box and puck gets cleared at the ice and there's an opportunity, but here might be an opportunity for Lemchugov. Oh,
nice little chop shot there, nice little L wedge there by Carr, flips it up and over Lemchugov.
Here's Hansen, but that's wide of the mark. Back out, an orthodox clearance from O'Connor, but anything in the way will do. Sheffield send it forward now. There's 55 seconds remaining in the second period. Can they find that equaliser before the buzzer sounds? Connolly brings it forward. Almost caught in possession, but Sheffield retreat. Hansen to Pelini. Back to Hansen. Down low. Manet is back. Robert Dowd. Dowd to Ben O'Connor. Up the boards, and O'Connor tries to find Eberle. 26 seconds remaining. There's time yet here for the Steelers. Down low, Eberle can't connect with a shot. Here is Melland out in front, just not anyone there on the doorstep, and Nottingham come away with it. Nice little stick handle there from Nottingham as they try to work an opportunity. Brett Bulmer, and Duba will hold on.
Yeah, good job out in front. Bulmer does a good job getting in the eyes of Duba. Sheffield just about allowing a pretty decent opportunity with under 10 seconds to go. Phillips charges it down. You can see that goes through the legs in front of the net of Crist. Talbot gets the one that gets the shot away. And then Duba hits him, and then he falls and finds the puck quickly.
5 seconds remaining.
Conley on the faceoff. Excellent job. And retrieved well by Sheffield to end that period and end that threat.
Important for Sheffield to get that goal back, though, when Nottingham have had such a good period. 3 goals. And then important for Valorant to at least get one back, start getting momentum going in the right direction.
Well, it is for sure. They had the opportunities. Carr played very, very, very well. He stoned 3 or 4 Sheffield players before Valorant scores from a tight angle. You know, the ones that that maybe should have beat him didn't, and the one that shouldn't have did. So Nottingham do a pretty good job taking the lead, doing what they needed to do. They just kept playing, and they were the first to out-battle Sheffield for the first part of that period. And Sheffield did battle back hard, and they did get one back. So it leads us into these replays here. It's power play goal coming up. A nice well-worked play by Nottingham. Little umbrella play, a shot that Duba has to come across his crease and throw out his left pad. And Perlini just sort of hanging around in that high slot. They're playing at a 1-3-1, so there's where Perlino is. He's the kick man in front or in the middle of the ice, and that puck comes straight out to him, and he just puts it into the back of the open net.
We'll just see, it's just staying with the play, isn't it? When it's there, Perlini, you can see, is Eyes are always on the puck, always working, always tracking back, and that backhanded shot just finds the back of the net.
It is. I mean, it's a good play all the way around from Nottingham because they move the puck east to west and north and south, and the shot that comes through, although Duba makes a good save on it, he can't do much to control the rebound sliding back across it. To be fair, that just sneaks it off the inside of the post by the looks of it. So it wasn't much of a control shot that goes through. It's a reaction shot from Perlini. I'm sure he would have loved to have been on the forehand and bury that into the net if he could have, but he doesn't quite do it. And then we come back with Armstrong and O'Connor. A little sauce pass through, and O'Connor right here tries to get it up, but can't quite do it as Matheson tracking back hard on him, and Carr does just enough to get the pad on it.
And this is the shorthanded goal for Brett Bulmer.
Yeah, it's just Bulmer just beats O'Connor on the pace, and right there you can see as soon as Duba misses the poke check, Bulmer's down wide, and he's got all the open net, but good work here. Not much O'Connor can do on the turn. He tries to get in there as best he can, and there it is, as everybody's laughing on the ice as Lemchikov takes the rubber puck for about the third game in a row that one of the fans hands it, and he's the one that's going to end up winning it for the fan. But again, the good hands there by Bulmer, a little bit coming through, maybe a little bit of a drag to his backhand to avoid that poke check. We'll get it here on super slow-mo as head up all the way, a little look down and a little look up to see. Nice drive through body, good position, nothing O'Connor can do right there.
Just has a little step, yeah, almost into the stick.
It does a little bit of a bobble, maybe a little bit fortunate from that angle there on super slow-mo that it kind of bounces maybe up and off Duba, and then and Bulmer just stays with it and puts it into that open net. But again, shorthanded goal. And then again, right away, a two-on-one back the other way, and Duba has to come up huge. And that's the penalty right there that Fox was all angry about, but it's a turnover there by Bettauer on the blue line, and bang, bang, bang. It looks like it's in the back of the net. So
almost looked like the chance had gone for Pelini, didn't it, when he lost the stick off his off the puck off his stick.
It did. It's here. This is what causes the chaos right there. They think that should be a penalty as a collision behind the net. But Bettauer's got the puck up here. He doesn't get the puck down in deep. It's turned over. Mellon doesn't get out from behind the net. And now everybody's reaching and tracking. And Pelini just makes a nice little shot over Duba's glove side.
I wonder if we'll see the tail end of it here. Here it is. Or just the trip there behind the net. Yeah. That's what Fox was.
But see right there, that go off the linesman or what again? And it's a little play quickly, and right there, Duba's there. He just misses it. I think he's already waiting for the shot to come through, and I think Perlini just puts it in a good spot.
And of course, this is the response from Sheffield from Marco Valorant.
Again, just another bouncing play, and Valorant doesn't give up on the puck. As he out battles, you know, a pretty big defenseman in Lapine, he's doing a pretty good job. He's got him to the outside of the ice. He's boxed him out pretty good if you watch. As it cycles back through, Kuka just throws it at the net. Look, Lapine's got him to the outside, and this happens to be that Valoran's a lefty and gets that second sort of chance and puts it into the net from really, really a sharp angle.
And it all tees it up quite nicely for the third period, just a goal in it. As we just see this Valorant slow-mo finish
one, two chances as it rolls up Carr's blocker hand. It rolls up and around the back and goes through. It's again a bit fortunate as it hits DeSantis in the backside as he's skating away from the net. So the netminder is
unsighted.
Not, yeah, he's unsighted, but he doesn't have the opportunity to make the save. So he thinks this puck is coming. So now he's got to find it as it bounces and bobbles around. And again, you know, like I say, Lapine's a big man to see the puck around in the first place. So is DeSantis, and it just sort of bounces to the right area, and Valorant is just quicker to react on it, although he does get two chances at it.
Back onto the ice. It's all to do in the third period. Just one goal in it as the Sheffield Steelers trail by 3-4 here. First time these teams have met in the Elite League so far this year. He met four times in the Challenge Cup, but Nottingham a bit of a different team. Jacob Hansen and Julian Talbot making all the difference. Tim Wallace has rallied the troops, and it's been an upturn in fortunes of late. So what can Aaron Fox muster from his Sheffield Steelers? And Ron, important to start, get a quick start at the start of the third period. What are some of the some of the stats that you've been having a look at between the break?
Well, just having a little look at the stats here. The stats page come up. It was 9-9 after period one. It's now stretched to 28-19. So a huge lead there for Sheffield in the shot category. But the power play is getting even 4-3, 3-4, whatever. You know, the penalty minutes are even. Power play, penalty kill, in and around the same. Save percentage a little bit up and down. But Carr, that period, to be fair, kept Nottingham in it. Obviously, they did get the opportunities to score a couple of goals. Duba, they did make a couple of decent saves, but a power play and a shorty to get them going. And then Sheffield did try to recover fairly quick, but Carr made three or four fantastic saves that kept the game at 4-2. So 4-3 going into the third period. Sets it up pretty nicely here, to be fair. We've got 20 minutes to see who wants to take this game to the next level. And they want Nottingham to stretch it out, or Sheffield need to show something here to get back into it.
You said it's poised quite nicely here as we start the third period. Nottingham win the face-off, get it to Pellini. Opts to just dump it in. Duba's behind the net to recover. Pellini capitalises on the loose puck, and Nottingham have got an opportunity. High blocker save, and it tried to bat it away. Michael Davies, and here it's going to come for Lemchugov. Just a bit too much on the pass. Need to play it forward. Fallerand trying to chase down Fick. Brought forward by Connolly. Connolly into the blue line, into the high slot. Gets a chance away, and Duba just gets a glove.
Again, that's way too much backing in by both Kuka and Brocklehurst. You can see Connolly coming through here. Speed. Now look where the Sheffield defenseman. Wait. Look, top of the circle, below the Steel's fault sign. And Connolly with speed is an easy play to get through. That's way too deep. Sheffield got to stand up at the blue line and take some control of their own area. You cannot keep allowing that attacking player coming through the middle of the net or the middle of the ice with that much speed, or you're going to get burnt big time.
Duba just pauses it behind the net, and Brocklehurst will bring it out. It's a little dangle to get around this man. Gets it forward to Dowd. Dowd now attacking with speed, but there's a stick in there from Ballmer.
Strange bounce again.
Just whistled through the crease, didn't it? And Carl makes the stop eventually.
Yeah, you can see the difference right there. You look at Nottingham. Robert Dowd trying to get up and through the neutral zone and into the end zone, and Nottingham player quickly on him, not allowing him any time and space. And what happens? He pushes him to the boards, makes the puck go in and around. A funny bounce brings it back out in front for Armstrong and Lemchugov. But again, Nottingham doing a good job holding the blue line, forcing Sheffield to the outside. And Sheffield have to recognize that that's one area that maybe they need to tighten up to. It's not the first time it happened throughout this game so far.
Kvist gets it forward, and Talbot will chase. Betau's in the corner, gets it to Armstrong. Lemchugov takes over and keeps possession, now brings it away, gets it forward, and Sheffield can start on the attack again. Troncinski trying to work the pass into the crease to try and find Armstrong. Now it does come to Armstrong. He tried to go back door, and there was no one there. Nottingham clear, and that's going to come all the way back down the ice.
Nottingham doing a pretty good job collapsing down in front of their own net there. A bit of an errant pass, a bit more control for my liking would have been better. A little bit of a hard pass through three or four guys out in front, and the only one that was willing to accept the pass was Lapine, and he just does the easy thing. It just sort of floats it down the ice.
Mullen takes the face off and loses out. Nottingham come away with it, but Sandstrom's again nuisance of himself. Mullen ends up losing his stick. Ebley across to try and retrieve it, and now he does. Tanner Ebley with space in front of him, if he can find it, opts to go wide, back in front. Eric Mullen is out in front. Oh, a chance there for Eberle. Sandstrom, it's high off the boards, but it's still alive for Sheffield. Here it is for Eberle. Down low, Eric Mullen. That energy line. Aaron Fox looking to get something going. Eberle-Sandstrom line. Betauer, cross-ice pass. It's better from Sheffield. Shot comes in there, but it's high. Now back out into centre ice. Betau was slightly off balance when he tried to make that pass, and Nottingham are going to come away with it. Here's a chance. Oh, it's still alive. Oh, everyone thought Duba had covered it up, and actually, the puck was still active.
Yeah, and you can see the difference there. Nottingham attacking with three players through the neutral zone. Sheffield forwards lazy coming back. In my eyes, from up here,
making all the hard work for two Sheffield defenders. And what happens? Dubé has to come up with another huge save. So again, you can't be playing us and them. You got to be playing as five and got to be helping each other out all the time.
Follerand. Tied into the netting. Comes off the stick of Deutsch. The White House doing everything it can to try and raise the atmosphere in here, get the fans to buy in, and hopefully that can translate down onto the ice.
Yeah, the biggest thing to get the fans into it is some Sheffield pressure and a goal coming out the end of it, and then we'll see a different game. But again, you still got nearly 17 minutes of play left here as Nottingham get the advantage again to get into Sheffield zone.
Sam Herr has it behind the net with Davey Phillips at his back, just pinning it in on the boards. Back out to Deutsch. That's the shot go, and a good block there from Marco Valeran, putting his body on the ice. Puck kind of hops up on Dubé and just manages to adjust his body in time. That was unfortunate. Looking for the stretch pass to Valeran and just hit the Nottingham player. O'Connor has it behind the net, round to Connolly. Connolly with his head up, looking for a pass. That pass isn't quite onto Valeran. Now it does come for Marco Valeran. Into the corner, not quite enough on it for Daniel Fick. It's going to come back for Michael Davis. Scored in every one of the Sheffield Nottingham games so far this year that he's been involved in. Is he yet to have an influence tonight? Brocklehurst. Sent forward. Attacking with a little bit more speed, but still a bit static. Nice handling from Armstrong, and just as he was about to pull the trigger, there's a big collision there on the ice. I think it's just incidental in the end, but looked like the penalty is going to be called on Sheffield here.
No, it's just an offside, yeah.
Oh, is it just?
Yeah, Lemchugov, and you can't see which Nottingham player it was. Lakovic, as they come through the back of him, both go down very, very heavily. Both end up going off. Although looks Lemchugov has stayed back out.
Thought it would have been one of those harsh calls. Purely accidental, the collision between the two of them. And then they've kind of got up and realised there wasn't any malice in the collision. Back here for Brocklehurst. Flips it round to Armstrong. Puck seemed to take an age to arrive with Armstrong. And he's got being hustled and harried by Nottingham, by Jordan Kelsall. And Nottingham win it back.
Yeah, again, Nottingham using all the bench that they've got down in front of them, allowing the little bit of rest when needed. And Sheffield just staying with their three lines.
Hansen bringing it forward again. Aaron Fox not opting to use all of the options available to him at the moment. Just trying to keep possession, and maybe a bit of overplaying going on at the moment. Players trying to make things happen. Trocinski maybe holding the puck a bit too long and upends Hansen. No call on the ice, and here's an opportunity for Jonathan Phillips to stretch his legs on the forecheck. Pass to Deutsch. Deutsch challenged by Jonathan Phillips. Who else? Forward comes James Batawa. Batawa, it's flicked on, and here's an opportunity for Phillips. Oh, he's brought down there. He ends up in the back of the net. What's the call going to be here?
No, Andy Dalton looked as though he was going to call something and thought, No, and then he waved it off as he goes. We'll have a little look here. A bit better. Deutsch comes through.
Yeah. Is that a hold? You'll know better than me.
You know what? In a 50-50 play like that, I think you've got to give credit to the guy going on the offense, going through the middle of the ice. He's got two or three steps on a guy with speed. You know, tough call for the official down on the ice. And Phillips is saying exactly that, saying that maybe I'll give you a, you gave him a shot, but yeah, I think in that instance, I think it should have been.
Get another look at it here.
Yeah, we'll see right here. He's got a step on the inside. Puck comes through. The thing is, I think what they're calling is he doesn't have control of the puck, but is Jonathan Phillips going far enough and fast enough to get possession back on that play? I think that's what.
He throws it into the zone. Here's a chance of Valeran on the backhand.
Yeah, I think that's what the play is being called.
Now back on the blue line, looking for an option.
And that just hits Carr. That doesn't make a save. He just hits him.
I don't think he knew anything about that save. Now Sheffield with Ben O'Connor. Kevin Carr knew all about that save though. Got the leg pad out down well. Just checking his equipment after the play, having a little stretch.
Yeah, but that one coming through, you can see just from here, that just hits him. I think the official seems to say, not this one here, but the one before that. Because that one's easily controlled and thrown into the crowd. Good puck control there and good rebound control by Carr. It was the one before that from the left point that came through. It looks like it just literally hit Carr in the shoulder with all the traffic that was out in front.
Now we'll see Talbot against John Armstrong. This has been a really interesting battle so far tonight. Talbot wins that particular exchange. Nottingham come away with it. Now Sheffield recover. Get a shot away on the 360 spinner armour. Lets the shot go. Sheffield with an opportunity, and that's wide of the mark. More shots from Sheffield, but need to get a few more on target. Here is Lemchugov. Back to the point. Miscontrol there, and it gives Nottingham the opportunity to come away with it. Ben O'Connor, unfortunate there. He was thinking three steps ahead of where he was. Nottingham hold it in the zone. Back round to Phillips. Chop pass onto O'Connor. O'Connor does well to avoid the hit, but loses the puck in the process. Now he's got it back. Plays it off the boards and round. And Sheffield on the attack again. Bobbles up. It's controlled by Lapine. Now Dowd. Oh, Dowd turned up a blind alley there. Sam Herr just unleashed the hit. And meanwhile, further up the play, Connolly's rather Armstrong's battling for it. And Armstrong comes away with it. John Armstrong trying to use the body. Oh, and he tried to go to the backhand. He was so close. Now a shot coming in there. It's still alive for Sheffield, and they've equalised! That's the equalising goal for the Sheffield Steelers. We felt like it was coming, and it's Eric Mullins.
Yeah, Eric Mullins just stays in front long enough and out battles. Kuka with a good hard shot, too, but Armstrong sets it all up with a big drive. But Mellon does a good job getting in behind Lapine and just digs and digs and digs. Nice little football soccer move, and put the stick in an empty net, which what we said is not the White House getting the crowd into it. We needed a goal from Sheffield, and they finally battle through, and Carr was finally beaten on one. That brings the atmosphere up to life here with 12 minutes left to go, third period.
Interesting to see that Aaron Fox had thrown Eric Mellon on that John Armstrong line. Looking for a bit of energy. It was something to get the crowd going, and it certainly got them going. Retired here at 4. Well, 11:53 to go, and Sheffield have got their tails up, and they're away with Eberle. Eberle, will he go alone? Eberle still with the puck. Three Panthers players around him. Here is Eric Melland. Going back to that line, Mellon, pass him through the crease, but no one can get the touch.
Yeah, I think it's Sandstrom that's come off that line. Jonathan Phillips has gone on there with Eberle and Mellon. And that little tweak to that sort of third line has had a little bit of a spark here for the Sheffield bench.
Now that top unit comes out to see if they can finish the job. 11:31 remaining in the third. We're all tied up. Tronsinski with a shot. Again, another shot that hits Kevin Carr that he doesn't know too much about. Valorand into the slot, takes a deflection out in front, and Connolly almost profited. Adam Deutsch, much better from Sheffield. Tronsinski takes a little deflection off Davis, takes a bobble behind, and oh, a little shot there from Kevin Carr. What's going to be the call here? He's going to be called for a penalty. Yeah. Interference.
Yeah, it is Kevin Carr. Again, he goes out to make the play, which is exactly what he does. Connolly, for a change, doesn't actually get involved in anything. As we've seen in the past, the player that he is, go in there and give a little hack and whack, but he doesn't actually do anything. He stops to go the other way to chase the puck, and Carr gives him a shot in the back for his troubles, and not something that you want from your starter to do, as Sheffield have, as you say, got their tails up and get a little bit of momentum. You don't want to put them on the power play, because at the end of the day, they've had 3, 4, or 5. They're due as well now, just like Nottingham was.
So the man coming to sit the penalty in place of Kevin Carr is in the box. And the Steelers are on the power play. Valorand back to the blue line. It's the first job done. We've seen on the two previous opportunities, it hasn't quite worked.
Dalarant explodes his stick on a one-timer chance, which is just about what luck you get sometimes.
Sums up maybe the power play's evening tonight as Brocklehurst brings it forward. Lovely stick handling from him. Valorant, Sandstrom rather, in the corner, trying to win that back. Sheffield loses stick. Big hit there from Marco Valorant. And
nice hit too. Lapine comes back, but Valorant does an excellent job on that hit. That's a fantastic body check.
Davis gets it back to O'Connor, who gathers in the neutral zone. Valorant chasing back with Matheson.
Yeah, I'm sure we'll see if we get that on the replay, but you'll see, I think it was Ollie Betteridge come through the middle of the ice with his head down. You can see right here, Lapine makes the pass right here. Betteridge is not seeing right there as he turns into the middle ice. Valorant's already there, and that's shoulder to shoulder. That's an A1 perfect, absolute body check that you show any kid anywhere how to do it in mid ice. That's exactly how you do it.
107 remaining on the power play, but the Steelers are in the wrong end. Lakovic against Brendan Connolly. Comes back on the Steelers' side. They can set up behind the goal again. Ben O'Connor just allows the line change in front of him. On comes Robert Dowd, Troncinski, John Armstrong, Nikolai Lemtugov. Just enough on that pass to see them through. Here comes Robert Dowd as we've got 46 seconds remaining on the power play. Dowd circles back in the corner. Back out to the half boards. Trzinski's an option at the back door if they can find him. Offers himself. Back to the blue line, O'Connor. Now Trzinski on the one-timer and it's wide. Armstrong checks back. He's got 2 men at his back, nowhere to go. Needs options. The option was Lemtugov, but he's uncharacteristically lost the puck. Back to Trzinski, but the body angle was all wrong to take the shot there. Back to O'Connor. Takes the deflection out in front. Trzinski again calls for the puck. O'Connor, backhand, flips it towards Armstrong. Now here it is to Trzinski! Oh, what a save that was from Kevin Carr!
Everybody on this side of the ice, we're up and ready to cheer that goal, and Kevin Carr, fantastic save.
Well, I tell you what, we saw a couple of fantastic saves in the NHL this week. Marc-Andre Fleury, and I think that was up there from Kevin Carr.
Oh, fantastic save. Look at this diving. He just gets there. Look at that. And that's just a never give up on the play and making sure you do everything in your power to keep that puck out of the net, especially when it's his penalty that's put him shorthanded.
The last thing you want to do, concede a penalty like that and then give up a soft goal that ends up costing you the win. Connolly, Melland got the equaliser. Now Nottingham come away with it with Christ. Now it's their turn to go forward with Brett Palmer in the corner. Two Steelers players trying to win it back. Here it is with Connolly. Connolly gets a shot away, down low. Good collapsing from Sheffield to block the shot. So Connor, little 360 from Jonathan Phillips, and Sheffield break. They need options though. Flick forward on Carr's net. Now it's going to come back, and lovely footwork from Jonathan Phillips to work an opportunity where he's able to play the puck on. Hansen misses the puck, and that gives an opportunity for Eberle, but he's all on his own. Needs support, and Eberle at the tail end of a shift there. Saw an opportunity. No support for him though. Now Talbot brings it forward for Nottingham. Slower pace to his skating now. Aerial route to Sam Herr, and Sheffield come away with it through Valorant. Out to Connolly. Davis is an option through the zone. A good stick there from Nottingham just to interrupt the pass. And now Nottingham come away with it. Here it is to Hansen. He's got Sam Herr. If he can find him, he can't. 7:16 left to play in this one. It's the Steelers 4, Panthers 4 in the Elite League. Again, a weird bounce off the ice. We had a couple of them tonight. Saw another one there. Connolly in his own zone looking for options. Cross ice. Now Malmquist brings it forward. battle out in front. Again, Connolly jumping up in the play. Lemtugov, cross-ice pass, but isn't controlled by Armstrong. Maybe he can reach it now with his long reach. He can't. Around the boards, and Sheffield will have to go all the way back and start again. But it's icy.
Yeah, again, you look at John Armstrong trying to force his way down the outside. Can't quite get past the Nottingham defenseman, but Robert Dowd is quick to the puck again through the middle of the ice. As you see Mellon on the bench there, Eric Mellon. His goal tied it up 4-4 a few minutes ago.
What a signing and what a find he's been there. Brought in as a player that was essentially a bit of cover for, you know, when we pick up these injuries to forwards or defensemen, and all of a sudden Malmquist almost picked it out of the air and fashioned himself an opportunity. And now Armstrong with a chance. Can he cut onto his forehand? He just tried to, and it just deflected out. But coming back to that point about Mellon, you know, he was a bit of a underwhelming signing when he was first announced, and it's really proved to be a real asset to this team.
Well, at the end of the day, everybody can't be an absolute superstar signing. I mean, you have to have players that are willing to do whatever it takes to win the games as well. You have your skilled guys that are there to put the puck in the net when they get the opportunity, but if you don't have anybody to get them the puck, it ain't going to go in the back of the net, is it? So he's one of those guys that can play sort of both ways, both ends, like you say, forward and defense. And he's got decent hands where it gets in tight like that and can put the puck in the net.
John Sinski forward now, and here is Eric Mellon trying to win the puck back.
There's going to be a hooking penalty. Looks like it's going to be Eberle on the play. As again, as that puck gets played out by the blue line, gets his stick stuck up in the hands of the Nottingham defenseman, I think it was. Again, from where we are, it's tough to see some of the numbers when you try to call it out, especially in play like that. So we too have to see sometimes on the replay.
This could be crucial as Nottingham go on the power play. Palmer holds it in, and here's Jonathan Phillips shorthanded. One-on-one with Kevin Carr. Jonathan Phillips, just played it wide, but the chance is maybe still there. Jonathan Phillips, the referee, just slightly gets in his way and tries to stick lift on Pellini. Pellini opts to just come back and reset. More time eeks off the penalty. Pellini back to the blue line. Deutsch. Matheson down low. Roll. Deutsch. Bormer shoots. Save from Duba. Again, Brett Bormer for his second of the night. Through to Matheson. Cycles back to Adam Deutsch. 54 seconds remaining. Matheson, Pellini! Just wide. Sheffield hanging on at this point as the puck deflects out.
Yeah, up and out over the glass. It hits the top of the glass, but here's the opportunity for Phillips. I think it's Deutsch that comes back and does a great job just doing enough.
Just a stick across.
Just a stick across, which is enough. Is usually Jonathan Phillips is off to the races. It's very, very difficult to catch, but fantastic working play by the defenseman to get back into it. And again, Carr was more and truly ready for that one as he came down the ice. If you watched his body language.
Came racing out of the net, didn't he? As we've got 33 seconds now remaining on this power play for the Nottingham Panthers. Sam Hare comes forward. He's got two Steelers players. Comes back to Connolly. Out wide. Looking to set it up again. Back to Connolly. Thinks about ripping one, cuts inside, looking for a pass. Who's the option? That's the option at the back door. Rips one, it's high and wide. Sam Herr, well, to just pull that back in. There's a shot out there, and Eric Melland is first to it. Ends up hitting DeSantis in the back of the helmet. Didn't know too much about that. Sometimes they're the opportunities that end up costing you when that little bounce of the puck goes the wrong way. Think. And Nottingham tried to build again. Lakovic. Back to Daniel Fink. Connolly. Looking for the option. It's not on, so he just chooses to come back as the power play expires. 3:26 remaining in this game. It's still the Steelers 4, Nottingham 4. As Duba gets down low. Makes a save. Connolly helps it on for Valorant. Davis is ahead of him. Michael Davis, can he fashion a shot? He can't. Just again, just slightly overhandles the puck. Matheson, blue line, red line, blue line. Comes up against an orange wall though. Sent round the boards. Then flick forward, looking for Dowd. Dowd controls with his leg pads, trying to find Trzoncinski, but it was well read by the Nottingham defenceman and then well read by John Armstrong. The game really breaking up at this point as Malmquist gets it out wide. Jonathan Roll. Back for DeSantis. Flicked down the wing and Sheffield recover. Lemtugov. Lovely cross-ice pass there. And Sheffield not quite able to. Oh, they've won it back. Now Sheffield break into the zone. There's a soft pass in the end on Kevin Carr. He just chooses to freeze the puck with 2:12 remaining.
Yeah, Robert Dowd does a great job on the forecheck. Pressures hard against the Nottingham defenseman. Wins the puck away and finds John Armstrong coming late. A nice little cut inside. A reactionary play by the Nottingham defense there. As you can see him spin around. I think it's Connolly that this spins around quick enough and just dribbles it along down to Carr.
Talbot with a kind of swinging stick at that point. Just didn't have to take the sting out of Armstrong's shot. Connolly with the backhand flicks it forward. That's the final 2 minutes now remaining. Steelers 4, Panthers 4. Is there another twist in this tale? Seen it so many times when Sheffield played Nottingham. What is it about these games? As the net's just knocked off its moorings. So with 1:41, we'll have a break in play.
Yeah, Conley and Eberle go crashing into the near side post on Carr. Having a little discussion as to how that worked out. He says, I was going behind the net. Like, no, you're going in front of the net, and I just kept my body position. That's exactly what they're saying. I was giving you around the net. Why are you going through the goalie? You're going into the net. So all it does is allow both teams to get a change in the defensive unit out there that Wallace wants and the offensive unit that Fox wants.
So Fox goes with his top line unit, almost falls kindly for Davis. Just hasn't quite fallen for Michael Davis tonight. Talked about his influence at the top of the show and what he's meant and how he's been missed. 6-game suspension, 18 points in 18 games, 9 goals. Played in 3 of the 4 cup games against the Panthers, scoring in all 3. 1:31 remaining. Has he still got a part to play tonight? Brocklehurst will bring it out. Sends it up the boards towards Valorant. 1:18 remaining. Connolly trying to win it back from Bulmer. Nottingham happy to play with it in their own zone at the moment. Kvist. Ben O'Connor. Now we'll get a change. We'll go for the Armstrong line for Sheffield. Valorant stays out there for the moment. Trying to win it back behind the end boards as we enter the final minute. Down to 40 seconds remaining now. Davey Phillips trying to think about going in there to win it back. And in the end, leaves it to Valorant and Connolly. Malmquist. We're into the final 30 seconds now. Nottingham bringing it over the red line. Davey Phillips back. Heavily. Deutsch. Again, Nottingham dump it into the offensive zone for the Steelers to pick up. Eberle down to Ben O'Connor. in the corner. O'Connor's got Armstrong up the ice if he can find him. Went to try and pick out the pass to Dowd, and his finish is all square off the regulation. 60 minutes of hockey, couldn't separate these two sides. The Sheffield Steelers 4, the Nottingham Panthers 4, and we're heading to overtime.
Yeah, an excellent job by Sheffield getting the goal that they needed to do to get this game back into overtime. I think a little bit more tilted towards the Nottingham net throughout that third period. A few more opportunities on Carr that he had to make some absolutely fantastic saves with. Obviously the one well back in the period, the one that just hits him in the shoulder, but everyone's going to remember the Trunczynski slap shot where he reaches across, takes away a guaranteed goal. He just never gives up on the play. He gets his glove in the perfect position. Doesn't hold on to it, mind you, but doesn't matter. It doesn't cross the line. And at the minute, Kevin Carr, to be fair, has made some absolutely wonderful saves, second period and now in the third, to keep this at 4.
Aaron Fox just selecting which players he wants out there for the overtime period. Who's the momentum with at this point, Ron?
You know what, to be fair, it's pretty much even throughout the game. It's been shifted back and forward a little bit, but 4-4 after 60 is probably fairly close to what it should be if we really think about it.
Let's take the opportunity to have a little look around the league. Cardiff all tied up with Belfast. They've gone to overtime as well. 3-3 in that game. Dundee 7-3 over Coventry. Guildford and Glasgow. Guildford are leading that one 3-1. And Fife and Manchester is tied up 7 minutes into the third period as well. So plenty of games pretty even at this point. We start 5 minutes of 3-on-3 hockey. So Nottingham go with Sam Herr, Mark Matheson and Brett Pellini. And Sheffield gone with Valorand, Davis and Brocklehurst. The first opportunity will come the way of Nottingham. Matheson bringing it forward now. Pellini's the man out in front. Checks back. Looks for the man out in front. Sam Herr opts to go all the way back and use all of the ice out there in front of him. The thing with 3-on-3, plenty of space out there for these quick players to use as Herr uses his speed down the wing, puts the shot in there, and Duva holds on. To the shoulder.
Yeah, you're exactly right. If you don't have anything, you see it plenty if you watch NHL stuff. Guys will take the puck all the way back and they'll start doing stuff where they can get that speed. And right there, Sam Herr beats Valorant on the turn. He has to switch him off. And that allows Herr to get down and get a good shot that Davies has to pick him up. So smart play when you can use that full ice and you have some good speed to get into it.
So both teams take the opportunity to change. Ben O'Connor over the top for Robert Dowd. An opportunity here for Sheffield. Dowd, can he round Connolly? He can, but poke check there from Kevin Carr.
Yeah, good play there by Carr, diving out, recognizing that Dowd has somebody hanging all over him, and the poke check works for him.
Malmquist gets it back to Connolly. Connolly, there's almost a chance there for the man on the far-hand side. Comes back to Connolly. The other Connolly for Sheffield gets a stick in there, and Ben O'Connor just tried the stretch pass, and there was just a bit too much on it. It's going to come all the way back into Sheffield's zone.
Yeah, good work there by Nottingham on the back door. As you can see, Robert Dowd right here, that little stutter step right there. And now Connolly can't do anything because it's going to be a penalty. And then Carr recognizing that, doing, he does all the damage, not the Nottingham defenseman. That's a perfect play, basically, from all three players, to be fair.
Talbot wins the face-off, back for Adam Deutsch. Because that's exactly the situation you bring Julian Talbot in for. Offensive zone face-off. Here he is with it now, opting to cycle back into the neutral zone. The chip up ice. Trunczynski misses it.
Offside, yeah. Sheffield just about getting caught on a change there. It was an icing call, so they're trying to get off the ice when that puck goes out. Trunczynski and Eberle hop the boards in a hurry. Just about get caught by Nottingham, but bobbles around enough for the Sheffield players to get back under control.
3:30 remaining in this overtime period. Steelers 4, Panthers 4. Pellini against Armstrong. Armstrong comes away with it. Trunczynski has it. takes everyone by surprise and goes on a solo wrecking mission, as he's got a winner in him, Trondzinski. Two goals for him already on the season. Just does enough to paddle it back to Armstrong. Again, winds up, builds up the speed and comes racing down the left-hand side. Trondzinski almost... All the Sheffield fans knew what John Armstrong was trying to do there.
I think everybody knew what they were trying to do there.
Here is Armstrong, stays with it. Backhand shot, Armstrong just wide. And the Nottingham player's lost his stick, Sam Herr. Armstrong tries to flip it to Eberle. It's trapped in the corner. Eberle battling to win it back. He wins that battle, gets it back to... Here's Trondzinski to win it! Oh, and just at that moment, Eberle tried to pick up the puck behind the net, and what an unfortunate moment for your stick to get caught in the back of the net with Kevin Carr at sixes and sevens, doesn't know where the puck is. And Brocklehurst to Santis, Makovic. All the options used by both teams at this moment. There'll be some tired bodies out there as Fisk brings it forward for Nottingham. Again, winding up and using the speed. DeSantis is the option. Fist checked hard into the boards, and here's an opportunity for Valand. Is this a matchup Sheffield can take advantage of? Davis. Past one man. Davis winds up. His shot's wide. Plenty of opportunities for both teams in this overtime period. Are we destined for penalty shots? 1 minute 30.
Sheffield just about get caught, too many men on the ice there. O'Connor smartly leaves the puck alone.
Valorant into the slot. Oh, maybe could have been a bit more selfish and held onto it there. O'Connor with Malmquist at his back. Dowd comes back to help him out and rescue the situation. Robert Dowd bringing it forward now for Sheffield. What can he do? Nice stick handling out in front. Kevin Carr. O'Connor. Oh, and Connolly just tried the short-handed attempt. Or the short side attempt, rather. Matheson back to Talbot. Talbot with acres of ice in front of him now. Little stick lift there from Dowd, just at the point where Talbot was thinking about pulling the trigger. Back to Connolly on the backhand, out in front. Where's the puck? Sheffield have the puck. Little look up from Ben O'Connor to look at the clock. O'Connor, Sheffield almost caught on a change. Here is Trondzinski. Trondzinski to O'Connor to win it. It's Connolly. Brendan Connolly has been criticised so many times, late penalties in games, and he wins it in overtime with 21 seconds remaining. Brendan Connolly with the overtime winner, and the Steelers take it 5-4.
And you can see Carr right there. He goes, oh my God, I can't believe I got beaten 5-0 on that shot by Connolly. Connolly at the end of a long shift. Trondzinski's the one that comes off the bench and does the job. Connolly, as you said, sometimes the player that everybody jumps all over, but does what he needed to do, and that break the hearts of Nottingham again. In the last minute of a period or a game, although Nottingham do pick up a point tonight, with that lead going into the third period, I think they'll be the ones that are thinking that they may have deserved two.
Well, we said at the start we were expecting a barnstormer of a game, and that's certainly what we got tonight. Taking you back through it, 53 seconds, John Armstrong opened the scoring. Robert Dowd doubled the lead at 12:53, and then Jake Hansen with his shot. Rebound came out to Mark Matheson and buried against his former club for 2-1 at the end of the first period. And then the second really was Nottingham's period. Brett Pelini on the power play tied it up at 2-2 before Brett Bulmer on the short-handed attempt made it 3-2 Nottingham. Pelini then with his second. And it seemed like a long way back for Sheffield, but they stayed with it. Marco Valorant halved the deficit just before the end of the second, and then tying it up Eric Mellon. And then, of course, the overtime winner from Brendan Connolly. As the officials and players have just finished shaking hands. Who gets the Eddie tonight then, Ron, do you think?
Are you going to give it to the person who scores the overtime goal? I think that's what the crowd will probably want to see, to keep the momentum and the emotion going throughout the building. That's usually what the boos are for, are they not? Not the the five guys, not winning the the burger to go thing.
Certainly is. Listen to that noise for the Sheffield Steelers. Overtime winners against the Nottingham Panthers. 4 wins in 5 games over them this season. Talked about the resurgence they've had recently. They've been on a fantastic run. It's been ended by Sheffield. The Panthers were unbeaten in their last 7 domestic games. And that run has come to an end, ended by their rivals, the Sheffield Steelers. Kevin Carr gets the man of the match for the Panthers.
I'm not going to argue too much with that, with some of the saves that he actually made throughout the game. When Nottingham did stretch that lead, he could have very easily folded in the back of the net, and Sheffield got back into it. With the opportunity, second period, probably 3-4 at least that I can remember off the top of my head, that he made some fantastic saves. And then again in the third, so that it went into the overtime period.
Certainly without Kevin Carr and that save from Marek Chinsinski, we might not have had the overtime period. But just having a few words with, is it Michael Davis down on one knee there?
Hard to tell, to be fair, from up here. I can't see either.
Can't see any numbers from here, can we?
He's a lefty. Does that help? Well, it wasn't Valorant because he's doing the 50-50. Oh, shirt off the back. Oh, no, see, it was 50-50. Getting a bit carried away.
What does a win like this do for confidence, really?
Well, it gives him an awful lot of confidence when he tries to pull that wad of cash out of his pocket, that's for sure. Well, it's like anything. It showed that, you know, they got up, they got the lead, they gave up the lead, they came back. So for as much as it's a back-and-forward game, you know, both teams are going to take positives out of here. They both got the point at the end of the day. Sheffield obviously getting the extra one. Nottingham doing a good job. Not quite there at the end. Had to rely on the netminder, but that's what you have a netminder in there for. He's got to do what he needs to do to keep the game where they can. But confidence-wise, I can't see either team not going into tomorrow or the next weekend with a lack of confidence or without any confidence. There's some good hockey play, some good opportunities at both ends of the rink. You know, some great plays by players on both sides.
Of course, there's still games underway. We'll bring you the results of the other games that are going on around the league. But some great matchups already. That Cardiff-Belfast game. Well, Belfast have taken that one in overtime. Dundee-Coventry, that's still in the third period. 7-3 Dundee up over Coventry. Guildford 4-2 up against Glasgow. That's in the third period. Obviously this game here, 5-4 in overtime, and then 5 Manchester, that's 2 minutes into overtime there, so 3 games tonight going to overtime. Just shows you how competitive this league has really got now. Brendan Connolly gets the man of the match. for scoring the overtime winner with 21 seconds remaining to take the 5-4 overtime. So, of course, that means we're going to have an edit. Gets some speed up and then takes his seat in the penalty box. Couldn't be anything else for Brendan Connolly, could it? And all the Steelers players cram into the penalty box with him.
I'm having a little tea party in the penalty box is what it is.
So just taking a look at what that means for the league tables as we stand at the moment, obviously with Glasgow losing. As all the Steelers players cram into the box. Can they get everyone in there?
They should do. Big enough penalty box.
Will Duba get in there? What about Melland? Oh, just a sit on the step.
Now they got to try to get out.
Just taking a look at the Elite League standings as we have them now, with Glasgow losing 4-2 as it stands to Guildford. Glasgow on 23 points, Sheffield on 22, just a point behind. And then we've got Cardiff, obviously with games in hand, on 21 points. Belfast on 20 and 4th. Coventry with 18, 5 move up. If it remains as it is at the moment, to 16 points. And then Nottingham pick up the 1 point today, tied, 6th, 7th and 8th, all on 16 points. And it just goes to show how tight it is this year in the league. You know, anyone can beat anyone on any given night. I guess the question is whether or not Glasgow can stay the course.
We've got a long way to go, to be fair, so where we are now is not going to be where we are at the end of the year. I can pretty much guarantee that.
Well, thank you for joining us on Steelers TV Live. Thank you to the team behind the scenes that make it all happen. There'll be some goals on Facebook and Twitter coming up later on. And, of course, the interviews from Aaron Fox. We leave you here with the news that the Sheffield Steelers have beaten the Nottingham Panthers by 5-4 on overtime. Good night.